AMD admits that there is an issue with the gaming performance data that it shared before the official release of its 9000 series and posted an article about it, which is interesting. The game performance differences between its results and the reviewers' results, including mine, of course. For our Ryzen 9000 launch, AMD internal labs generated data that showed a 9% average generation uplift in 1080p gaming versus Ryzen 7000 series and an average of 6% higher performance across more than 30 games when compared against the competition's best. Not all reviews see these results, reflecting the complexity of high performance PC testing today given the number of system and software variables. There are several factors specifically creating these differences in some Ryzen 9000 reviews. The AMD Gaming Test Suite includes a wide range of esports, AAA and popular older games combining CPU and GPU bound titles. The test suite's makeup can significantly influence game performance conclusions. My comment: yes, we reviewers also use a wide range of games, including new and older titles. AMD tested Intel configurations using comparable DDR5 6000 memory and Intel default settings baseline power profile, which can have a small impact on gaming performance. My response: so, they used the deadbeat Intel default baseline profile, where Intel CPUs lose notable performance. In my comparison data, I didn't use the highly restrictive Intel baseline profile. AMD also tests with Windows virtualization-based security, VBS, enabled. This is the default Windows behavior, and Microsoft recommends activating VBS to improve security. However, it can affect gaming performance. My response: since it is the default setting and has to do with performance, why should we deactivate it? The Zen 5 architecture incorporates a wide branch prediction capacity than prior Zen generations. Our automated test methodology was run in admin mode, which produced results that reflect branch prediction code optimizations not present in the version of Windows reviewers used to test the Ryzen 9000 series. My response: first clue, AMD has an automated test methodology, so they don't actually play a game scene, but a bot does that for them. It makes sense to run this test suite in admin mode. Also, AMD informs us that they used a version of Windows that is not yet available to the broad audience. This is weird, given that they should know that most reviewers would use a stable Windows version. In light of this, the Ryzen 9000 series delivers leadership performance across content creation, productivity, and AI applications. On a generational basis, the Ryzen 9000 series delivers a 10% improvement in productivity in creative workloads, 25% improvement in AI workloads, and 5-8% improvements in gaming over the Ryzen 7000 series. I noticed an improvement in single-thread applications and in rendering, but the overall performance of these chips is far away from what I expected. Only if I don't take into account gaming performance and the AI DA benchmark, where the Ryzen 9000 has too low AES performance, the 9950X is almost equal to the 7950XD. But as you can see from this graph, the Intel i9-13900K takes the lead from the Ryzen 9900X. I should note, though, that the PL1 and PL2 were set at 250 watt for the Intel processor, so its power consumption is notably higher than the 9900X. The gaming performance of the new chips leaves much to be desired, unfortunately, and the power consumption during gaming. With the 13900K unlocked PL1 and PL2, the difference in power consumption during gaming from the 9900X is close to 40 watt. It's a notable but not dramatic difference, given that it allows a 2 years old chip to beat a new one. I know, of course, of the degradation issues reported by various users about Intel's 13 and 14 generation chips, and I don't agree with the crazy high power consumption of Intel chips. But still, this is a 2-year-old design. AMD mentions that if we use the 24H2 Windows version, we will notice a vast improvement in some game titles, while others won't be affected. AMD works with Microsoft to roll out this Windows update soon, and once it does, we will have to retest all of its CPUs and see what is going on. That's all, guys. Bye-bye.